All right, here we go. Today's lesson is the start of our algebra part of the term. And a lot of people say, oh, I've never used algebra in my life. Well, I think the thing is that people are using algebra all the time. They just don't even realize they're using algebra. And it actually has a lot of very useful purposes, but you're actually using it all the time and you don't even know it. Now, the example I wanted to give you is, let's say you're in the crazy business of selling bananas. And let's give bananas the letter B. Makes sense, doesn't it? All right. Now, you never know how many bananas a customer is going to buy. I remember last time I went shopping, I bought four bananas. Okay. So you're in the business of selling bananas, and you want to come up with some way of quickly working out how much it costs when a customer comes in, and you've counted up the number of bananas that they bought, and you can tell them how much it costs. Okay, so this is a really simple example, but this is an example where people are using algebra all the time. Okay, we don't know how many bananas someone's going to buy, but it's a number of bananas, we know that much. Okay, so we could come up with the expression 2b. Oh, now I missed a bit. I was actually your. Bit of a rip-off merchant, but it's you're selling bananas for $2 each. $2 per banana. That's crazy. So the expression that you would have created, and you don't even know that you've created it, is the expression 2b. So say the other day I bought my four bananas, I would come in and you would go, okay, well, two times four, you use four instead of b, and you'd say, okay, well, Mr. Campbell, you owe me $8. The next customer's got a family of 12. And each kid eats three bananas each, so they buy 36 bananas. It's a lot of bananas. So you would then go into your little expression, you'd say 2 times 36, and I don't need my calculator because I'm a math teacher, and you would say, okay, thank you, that's $72. And you could use your banana expression to quickly calculate how much a customer needs to pay, no matter what number of bananas they buy. And you never know what number of bananas someone's going to come in and buy. But bananas is given the letter B, the number of bananas that they buy. So that's an example where people are using algebra and don't even know it. Now, before I launch, what we're really getting into this series of lessons is actually how to solve equations. And then what we'll get near the end is we'll give you some problems and you will be challenged to write an equation for that problem and then solve it. So solving equations. But before we do, let's go back over and remind ourselves of a few of the basics. Okay, firstly, in algebra we use letters. It might be B for bananas or X or Y. You've obviously seen X or Y, you might use the letter A. Okay, and these letters are called what you guys probably don't remember, and I don't blame you. Get all these crazy words put at you, pronumerals, or I prefer to call them variables. Okay. And the thing with variables is the first part of the word in variables, my computer's just frozen up a little bit here, it does this now and then, is the first part is vary. Now it's not quite spelt right, but vary, V-A-R-Y, vary means things change. Okay. And so these letters represent numbers, but those numbers can change. So, for an example, one problem might have B, in my case, was four bananas. X might be 12. Y might be, I don't know, might be 1.25. You can get decimals in there. A might be 1,084. Who knows? We don't know what these are until we know the problem. Or maybe we have an equation and we need to solve the equation to find out what the value of the number is. But these letters or pronumerals or variables represent numbers. Okay, so that's number one. Pronumerals, they're just letters, variables. Now, a few other terms that you need to, a few other, I don't know, definitions would be a better way of expressing it, to be honest, that you need to know. One would be the coefficient. So if I had 2a, okay. Now, you've got to remember in algebra that 2a really means 2 times a, but we don't bother to write the times in there. Okay, we just write 2a. Now, 2a, in this case here, 2 is multiplying the value, the number a. So if a was 5, then 2a would be worth 10. If a was 10, 2a would be worth 20. So what we call this guy here is the the coefficient. Okay, and it multiplies our variable. So that's the coefficient, all right? But that's just a fancy number that multiplies the variable. Okay, so if a was 15, then it'd be the value of this term here would be 30. So that's the first one, coefficient. All right, now, well, actually, I should have maybe just left that as it was. But let's say that we have, now, 2a is also put together, is also known as a term, okay, a term in an expression. So we might have 2a plus 7, okay, 2a plus 7. Now, in this case here, plus 7 is also another term. We have term 2 here, okay, so we have term 1 and term 2, and together, these guys have now made what we call, I think it's frozen again just quickly, we have made an expression. So these things have made an expression, okay? So, but a single term is also an expression, but we often see them with more than one term in them. Now another thing too, we don't really know the value of 2a until we know the value of a. 2a could be worth anything. If a was 7, then 2a is 14. If a is 5, as I said before, 2a would be 10. So that can change. We don't know what 2a is worth. But this guy here, term number 2, he's not going to change. And we give him the name, he's a constant. Okay? So in this expression, 2a, it could be any value at all, depending on what we say the value of a is. But what we do know, no matter what value a is, this guy is always going to be worth plus 7. And another little trick too, just to be careful of, this is actually really plus 2a, but we don't bother to write the plus out the front. That's some of the basics that we have there that you guys need to remember. Now, I'll give you one last little thing before we move on, because sometimes terms can be a little more complicated than those basic ones. Okay, you might have 2a to the power of 2. Okay, now that would be a 2a squared, as you were talking about it. Now, another thing that we do need to be careful about, okay, is what we call like terms. Okay, like terms. Because we can add and subtract like terms and put them together. Now, sometimes you might look at this and say 2a, okay, and think, well, they're like terms. They've both got a in it. But of course, they have a squared and a, kind of, it's a bit tricky, but it's actually a to the power of 1. But we don't often write the one there. We don't bother writing the one. Okay, but it's a to the power of 1. Okay, you need to be careful. Okay, like terms have the same pronumerals or same variables. Okay, same pronumerals, but they also must be the same power. So these guys are not like terms. Okay, because it's 2a squared and 2a. They look like they might be like terms because they've both got a in it and no other pronumeral, but they are not like terms. Okay. Now another little trick you need to be careful about also. Sometimes too, like terms might have more than one variable in them. So you might have 2ab, okay, a And you might have 4BA, which is a bit weird. But now, as a matter of fact, are they like terms or not is the question. Well, do they have the same pronumerals in them? They both have an A. And are they both to the same power? Yes. They both have a B in them. Okay, so are they the same power? Yes, they're both to the power of one. Okay, coefficients don't matter. Okay, we're looking at the pronumerals. So really, it has the same pronumerals. Both of those pronumerals are to the same power. And as a matter of fact, we can then say these guys, even though they're swapped around, are like terms. Okay, they're like terms. Now, later on, we're going to talk more about more complicated expressions, but sometimes what we need to do is to be able to simplify expressions. And if we have like terms in an expression, well, we can basically collect them up. So we might have 2a squared plus 2a, which is not like terms, plus 6, which is a constant, plus, I don't know, make it simple, 4, so frozen up again just a little bit, give me a sec. Plus, come on, plus 4a. Okay, now 2a squared. He's the only guy in here with an a squared. There's no other terms with an a squared. So this guy is unique, so we'll put a square around him. Okay, now we have plus 2a. Now there's a plus 4a on the end. They're both a, they're both to the power of 1. So actually, they're both like terms. So what we'll do is we'll put a circle around them. Now include the sign out the front of the term. All right, and we've got to remember. Include the sign out the front. And the last guy we've got here is our constant. And he's the only one without a pronumeral, without a variable. So what we'll do is we'll put a triangle or something around him. He's different. Okay, so then to finish off now, we can simplify this expression, just make it smaller. We can have 2a squared plus 2a plus 4a is plus 6a, and then plus 6 on the end. And we've simplified that expression, okay, by collecting like terms. Now it's a little bit different when you're multiplying terms together. They don't have to be like terms. You can smash them all up into each other and make new terms. So, for example, on that one, you might have 2a times 3b. Okay, now if I expanded that out, we actually have 2 times a times 3 times b. Okay, rearrange that. We got 2 times 3 times a times b. 2 times 3 is 6. A times b, a, b. We don't bother to write the multiplies. And that all smashes together to make something completely brand new. So you just need to remember you are collecting like terms. It's just frozen up again for a sec. When adding or subtracting. All right, but enough about that. When the time comes, we'll spend more time on it. But look, that's some of the basics of algebra that you need to remember, and there's some of the skills that you're going to need and some of the terminology that you're going to need to remember to be successful in what we're doing here. So let's call that the first lesson there. We'll give you a little bit of a worksheet on identifying variables and coefficients and number of terms in an expression, and finding like terms and multiplying terms together. But that'll be our first lesson for today.